How to install MSI Afterburner in the year 2025. So, head over to the official website of MSI Afterburner and click on the latest version of the application. Currently, version 4.4.6 is the latest version. Yes, this beta version is recommended if you have any PC component or any computer device that was released after March 2023. If your whole PC was released before that time, then you might get the stable version of the app. Hence, I am currently going with the version 4.6.6. Now, after hitting this button, select the directory where you want to save the MSI Afterburner zip file, then click on Save. After that, head over to the location where you have downloaded that file, and simply right-click and extract the file on that same location. Now, move into that extracted folder, and double-click on the .exe file. Click on Yes when it asks you for administrative rights. Now, here's the most important thing. Please note this carefully. After double-clicking on that installation file, you will get this pop-up. Make sure to uncheck this second option, which says Norton 360 for Gamer. Now, even if you have got a free trial for this antivirus software with your newly purchased device, then still, I would not recommend installing this antivirus software, because it will just increase the load on your system and take over Windows Defender as your primary OS protection software. So please don't forget to uncheck this box and click the install button. Wait for a few seconds, and bam! Now select your language from here and click on OK. Click on Next. Click on the I accept the terms of the license agreement option, and hit Next. Now, make sure that the box beside RivaTuner Statistics Server is marked with the green tick. Hit Next, and choose the location where you want to save the software. Now, if you don't want any shortcut file, then check box here, otherwise click on the install option. And now, wait for the installation to finish. After that, the system will prompt you with the RivaTuner installation. Please don't hit the cancel button, as you compulsorily need this software to see the in-game statistics. So, here, follow the same steps as we did during the previous installation. Now after it's done, click on Finish one by one, and make sure to delete both the zip file and the extracted file from your Windows Explorer. Now, go to your desktop screen and search for MSI Afterburner. Open the app and you will come across this type of interface. Now, go to its settings, and simply, click on this monitoring tab. A sweet warning here. Please be extra careful while using this software. There's no need to tweak anything other than the ones I am showing here in this video. Don't change any other settings from the remaining tabs, if you don't know what you're doing, okay? Simply, just head over to the monitoring tab, and from here, you can choose which stats you want to see and monitor and which ones not during a benchmark. You can also hover over the graph name to learn more about the info each graph shows. Now, one by one, click on the graph name and checkbox on this show an on-screen display option. You can see that the graph's properties section is updated as in OSD. Now, choose your preferred graph one by one, and also, make sure that the graph name has a white tick mark beside it. If not, then hit the tick mark and then click on this option. You can also change the color of each graph value as you can see. Now after setting up everything, click on Apply, then OK. Then minimize the MSI Afterburner window. As you can see, both MSI Afterburner and RivaTuner are running in the background. Now let me launch a game. I am going to run Crash Bandicoot 4 for this video. Now friends, don't be like me and open RivaTuner immediately after the game boots. Otherwise, you might get a fatal error like this. So, wait for the game to start, and go inside any level or mission. You can see that the statistics have appeared already. After that, you need to press the start button to open RivaTuner from the taskbar. Now, the problem here is that, in some games, like this one, pressing the start button makes the screen go black, and you cannot access RivaTuner properly within the game. So, to solve this, go to the game's graphical settings, and set the screen mode from exclusive full screen to borderless full screen. Now, come back to the stage where you have been before. Press the start button, and open RivaTuner from the taskbar like this. You can adjust the size of your stats using the arrow-headed icons and the zoom slider from here. You can also increase the detection level if the stats are not showing up very late, or not showing up at all. Now after making all the adjustments to the stats, go to the game settings and set it to exclusive full screen as before. So guys, at the end of the day, this is how you can install MSI Afterburner in 2025, and benchmark your game and monitor your hardware. If you face any problem anywhere, then comment them down below, okay? Thanks for watching, and I will see you in another video.